Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. My name is Charles from Sprouta Web, and today we are going to cover which Elementor theme is the fastest. For my benchmarks today, I'm going to be using Elementor version 2.5.5, which was just released, and we're going to use that to compare 12 popular and common Elementor themes side by side using GT metrics and webpagetest.org. Now, in terms of how we selected which 12 themes to test today, I first started by going to Elementor's website. And they have an article entitled Which Themes Work Best with Elementor. The first one they mention is the Hello theme, and then if you scroll down a bit, they have a section called Free Themes for Elementor, and I noticed that a lot of these themes are actually ones that a lot of us use and are familiar with as well. So I see like Generate Press, I see Astra theme, I see Ocean WP, and so I selected a large majority of these. And then there were a couple that users recommended and asked for me to do as well. So I went ahead and included a couple of those as well. I didn't want to, you know, obviously there are tons of Elementor themes that we could test. I just went ahead and picked 12 that I thought were the most common and ones that Elementor actively has on their website, because I figure most Elementor users would be, you know, if they were to come to their website, they would see this list. So I started here. Now what I did was I took all those themes, I installed them on our dev site, and I have activated Astra as the first theme that I'm going to test. And in plugins, I have just Elementor version 2.5.5 installed. And you guys will remember from my last tutorial when we covered how to optimize Elementor sites and make them faster, one of the reasons why this is the only plugin that I have installed right now is because plugins actually generate server requests. And by default, they try to load style sheets and different scripts across every page, including a blank canvas page. So I didn't want that to mess up any of my baselines, so for now I just have Elementor, the free version, installed. Now from there I created a blank canvas page, and this is the page that we're going to go ahead and perform GT metric scans with each theme that we have to test. And the reason for that is because every theme actually has its own unique default theme template. And so I noticed across all their different, you know, initial settings, you know, some pages had sidebars, some had a footer with like four columns, and they weren't consistent. And so it wouldn't have given a fair read in terms of time or site load speed. However, with a blank canvas page, I'm literally not loading any content. So I'm not requesting a logo to be loaded. I'm not requesting a content section or a sidebar or a footer section to be loaded. The only things that will show up in my GT metric scan at this moment, since it's a blank page, are going to be scripts and files that are being requested from WordPress, Elementor, and the particular theme that's activated. And because we're keeping Elementor and WordPress consistent across the board, any changes to the numbers and stats are going to be due to the changes in the theme that we actually go through and change. Now, with GT metrics, that whenever you run a scan, it does a one-time scan. So I'm going to run that three times to get a composite average. And then what I'm going to do is also run the same scan with webpagetest.org, which is a separate entity, and they have their own servers and everything to test website load load speed. And what's cool about their tool is by default, they actually do three test runs and average that number together for you and give you a load time. I've noticed that GT metrics and webpagetest do actually measure, they tend to have different load times just by a little bit. But what I'm going to do is actually take the composite averages of both, and I'm going to average everything together. So GT metrics is going to be three scans, web page test is going to give us another three scans, and I'm going to average all that together. But what I'll do is I'm going to put all that information into the spreadsheet, and I'll share the spreadsheet with you guys, and kind of give you guys a full breakdown. At the end of the day, I'm going to have my average GT metrics load time, I'm going to have the webpagetest.org average load time, I'm going to average those together to get a combined average load time. So this is going to give me hopefully a more accurate overall estimate of how fast these blank canvas pages are loading. And I'll take a look at that in combination with the number of server requests and the total page size to help determine which theme is the most lightweight and loads the fastest for you guys. So what I'm going to do for the next couple hours, I'm going to get busy. I'm going to go ahead and run all these tests, fill out the spreadsheet, and I'll be right back with the results. Okay, so now that that's been completed, you'll notice here in the table I have all the results. So I have all the page speed and y-slow scores, as well as how large all the blank canvas pages were for every single theme. As well as the number of server requests, yada yada. In this section, these are the three individual GT metric scans that we ran. And when you average those together, that results in your average GT metrics load time. When we ran our three test runs using webpagetest.org, that resulted in these average test times. I then averaged our GT metrics and web page test times together for a combined average load time. Now, what I'm going to do is take all of our data and I'm going to sort it by the combined average to see who our winner is. And when I do that, I see that Hello Theme by Elementor actually comes out on top. And it was actually a super close race between that and Generate Press. But ultimately, Hello Theme had a slightly faster combined average load time. When I looked at the GT metrics load time, the difference was slight. It's about the same. It's slightly more pronounced, though. But the difference really showed when I looked at the number of server requests, as well as the blank canvas page size. In both these factors, Hello Theme still beat out all the other themes. The next closest in terms of the blank canvas page size is Generate Press, followed by Astra. And so for all particular means, I think the winner is Hello Theme. I would say a close second, maybe tie for second, would be Generate Press and Astra. Awesome. Well, everyone, thanks for watching and joining me today. I hope that this round of benchmarking tests was insightful and helpful for everyone. And you know what? If it was helpful and you guys are interested in having benchmarks be more of a regular thing, especially because with every theme and WordPress update, a lot of this stuff becomes more lightweight, I would be interested in learning which benchmarks you guys would love to see next. The next one that I'll be covering will be Elementor versus Divi versus Beaver Builder, because that's actually a pretty common and popular one that everyone's been requesting. So that would be the next project that I start working on, and I'll present my results here when it's ready.